JTV. Today I will be showing you PID control on Eaton Cutler-Hammer's HMX HVAC drive. In my scenario, I would like to maintain 75 PSI in a duct with a system capable of 0 to 200 PSI. I will set up this drive for PID control, which will be able to keep my duct pressure at a set level. If the HMX is in its default settings, then I will be prompted to enter the startup wizard on power up. This feature allows me to change what language I can use, daylight savings, time, date, and year. If I make a mistake in any of these selections, I can hold the back button for a couple of seconds to go back to the previous menu. Next, I can change my application. I will need to scroll to PID and continue to the next menu. Here I can enable or disable the bypass. I will keep this enabled. Next is where I will plug in my motor's nameplate data. This will change according to your motor and should have different values than the ones I will plug in. I will adjust the current to 1.8 and press OK. I'll keep the voltage at 230 volts and the motor frequency at 60 hertz. For my RPM, I will change this to 1700. I can move the cursor to the left and scroll down to make quicker changes. For minimum frequency, I will adjust this to 0 hertz. I will keep my motor frequency at 60 hertz. Next, I will adjust my acceleration time to 5 seconds. This will make it easier to see the motor ramp up to my desired speed. Then I will adjust the deceleration time to 5 seconds. Again, this is for a visual reference to see the change and should be adjusted according to how fast you want the application to stop. I will then change my start source hand to keypad and my start source auto to the I/O terminals. I can then change my speed set point in hand mode and in auto mode. Next is my feedback source, which is currently on analog input 2. I will change this to AI1. This means that my voltage input reference here will simulate my pressure transducer or feedback device that is measuring the pressure in my duct. Next is my process unit selection, which currently is in percentage. I can scroll down until I find PSI. There are many different types of units that can be used, but for my example, I am looking to create a set point for duct pressure. I will now be able to plug in the minimum value of my process unit. As I mentioned earlier, my system is capable of 0 to 200 PSI. I will keep this at 0 and then change the maximum process unit to 200. I will keep the gain at 100% and keep the integration time at 1 second. I will also keep the set point 1 source on the keypad. The display should show ready to start. All the settings I plugged in can be changed later, or I can hold the back key to go back. I will push OK to advance to the main menu. I will need to plug in my set point. This is parameter number 2.9.1.2.1. Knowing the number can make navigation easier by following the parameter number in the upper right corner. I will also navigate through the menu. First, I will go to parameter. Notice the number in the corner is 2.1. I will scroll down until I get to 2.9, which is labeled as PID controller. If for any reason I need to go back a step, I can press the back button for 2 seconds. I should now be at 2.9.1 for PID controller 1. I will advance to the next menu and go down to set points. This should be 2.9.1.2. Then I can push OK again to access 2.9.1.2.1 for keypad set point. Pushing OK will allow me to enter a subset menu where I can edit. Use the help to find out more or add to favorites. I will push the edit key to change the value. The blinking cursor will indicate that I am in edit mode. I will change the value to 75 PSI and then push the OK button. The number will stop blinking, showing that the value has saved. Then I will hold the back button down to go back to the subset menu. For demonstration purposes, I will scroll down and push OK to add to my favorites. I will continue to press the back button until I get back to the main menu. Next, I will press the hand off auto key in the right corner and change the value to auto. The status menu will show 75 PSI on the screen. I will press OK and then scroll to the motor current and press OK. This allows me to change the display. I would like to monitor frequency, so I will scroll down to output frequency and press OK. Then I will go down one more and change this one to PID1 feedback. As you can see, there are a lot of different options to monitor, and on the main menu is a way to monitor even more functions at once. With my desired setup, I will flip my start switch to run the motor. Right now, the motor ramped up to the maximum speed as my feedback device is signaling to the motor that there is only a small amount of pressure in the duct. As I slowly turn the analog input up, I can see the monitor show that my PSI level is increasing. Once at the desired set point of 75, I can see that the motor is starting to drop in frequency. I will then go above my set point and the motor will stop. It will not run until my feedback senses a drop in pressure, and I will simulate this by turning down the analog input. Eaton Cutler-Hammer's HMX HVAC Drive, along with thousands of other products and services, are available at Galco.com.